Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mohammad Ali and I am Associate Professor in the Department of Pharmacology, Multan Medical and Dental College, Multan, Pakistan. First thing first, I want to use this opportunity to thank Conference Series and especially Ms. Ashley for giving me this platform to disseminate my research globally, because I know the researchers sitting over here and listening to me are from Europe, America, Canada, Middle East, India as well. So I want to thank them as well for listening to me. Unfortunately, I was initially planned to go live, but due to heavy rain in my area and because of electricity issues, I was unable to, catch up with you. So anyways, the topic of my today's presentation or paper presentation is effect of Nilambo nucifera fruit on depression and associated comorbidities. So let's get right into it. So this is the outline of my presentation. Depression can be defined as a neurotic or psychotic state characterized by an inability to concentrate, alteration in sleep patterns, and feelings of extreme sadness, rejection, hopelessness, and also social isolation. Basically, it is a debilitating mood disorder with worldwide prevalence of around 4.4%. Prevalence in Pakistan ranges from 22% to 60%, with incidents reported recently in Karachi was around 47%. Karachi is the biggest city of Pakistan. Although we have different antidepressant agents available in the market, the allopathic medicines like SSRIs, tricyclic antidepressants, MAOIs, and atypical antidepressant agents. But apart from SSRIs, which are relatively safer agents, all other agents are associated with various side effects and they're expensive at the same time, and they have different drug-drug interactions as well. So now the world is now switching and encouraging the use of alternative medicine, the medicines or drugs which are derived from herbal sources. So my topic of today, my presentation of today is also about the activity of Nilambo nucifera fruit. This was actually a part of my PhD project as well. This is a wonderful plant, Nilambo nucifera, and I actually unfolds or discovered its fruit's different pharmacological aspects. So today I will be discussing its effect, which is useful for useful in states of depression. So I actually revealed its antidepressant activity, and how I revealed its antidepressant activity, we will be discussing it in a little while. So let's get right into it. So basically, Nilambo nucifera fruit. Just want to clarify one more thing, that before me, many researchers actually unfolded its various effects, leaving the fruit, effects of other parts of the plant, including the roots and the stem and other parts of it. But fruit was, untouched. Very limited literature is available so far regarding different pharmacological effects of the fruit. So I came forward and unfolded and discovered various effects of it. So fruit, Nilambo nucifera fruit, is basically derived from Nymphaceae, an Nymphaea family, and it is cultivated in the tropical regions of Pakistan, different regions of Sindh and upper Sindh especially, and the lower part of the Punjab, including my area from where I'm presenting myself on this video presentation, Multan, Muzaffargarh regions, and also from Kashmir region. Kashmir, famous name globally. So Nilambo nucifera fruit is cultivated especially in the water gardens, ponds, and lakes of different regions of Pakistan. Okay, let's discuss the traditional uses and the constituents of this amazing plant's fruit, Nilambo nucifera fruit. Traditional uses include fever, inflammation, insomnia, palpitation, hypertension, etc., etc. So people used to use it, but they were not scientifically proven unless active studies were conducted by me and various other researchers as well. But on this food, if I talk about this food specifically, so very limited literature was available before my research on food's different pharmacological activities. So I am the top researcher who focused on its food and unfolds different scientific and pharmacological activities of this fruit. So it has the presence of different useful minerals as well as vitamins as well. And the amazing thing is that it has the presence of different secondary metabolites as well, including flavonoids, saponins, tannins, and different alkaloids as well. So the purpose of my study, the use of flavonoids and vitamins have increased significantly these days to treat health-related problems. Available allopathic drugs are associated with various side effects, contraindications, and drug-drug interactions, which is a matter of concern. Hence, there was a substantial inclination in the demand of plant-derived medications. Moreover, very limited literature is available regarding use of Nilambo nucifera fruit for depression. So, this was my purpose of study. Before my research, no other researcher came forward to, reveal or focus on its effect on the depression or depressive states. So I choose it, and it was a part of my PhD research, and I did it. And I was pretty sure when I started this research that this study would surely help in the exploration of a novel agent from the plant source, and therefore may recommend the application of traditional medicines in humans. Traditional medicines, alternative medicine. So now let's talk about the materials and methods used to conduct this study. First of all, the approval was taken from the Departmental Research Committee and the BASR, Board of Advanced Studies and Research. Research work was executed or conducted utilizing the laboratory facilities of Pharmacology Department and the Research Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences, University of Karachi, Pakistan. Now let's talk about the extract preparation. So actually, 6 kg of fruit, it has different stages, purchasing to the freeze drying, which is the last one. So 6 kg fruits were purchased first from the local herbers, local fruits and vegetable market of Hyderabad, Sindh, Pakistan. Hyderabad is a city of Sindh province of Pakistan, a very famous city. And after washing them, seeds were peeled off from the pods. So I just want to clarify at this stage that fruit itself has two parts, the seeds and the pods. So chopped seeds were dried under shade for 6 days. The dried material was ground to coarse powder. The fruit pods were first dried under shade for 3 days and then chopped to fine powder. Now, seed powder together with the seed pod powder was soaked in 10 liters of 98% ethanol for 30 days. And occasional stirring and shaking was done until the color of the solvent became black. Now, after that, filtration was done with the help of Wattman number 1 filter paper, and the extract was filtrated, and then it was evaporated under reduced pressure with the help of rotary evaporator at around 40 to 45 degrees, and was then followed by freeze drying at minus 30 degrees Celsius. The solid lyophilized material so gained was saved at minus 20 degrees in a refrigerator for further use. So this was the seed pods when after drying, and this is its state after grinding. The seed dried seed pods on the left side of this picture, and on the right hand it is the grinded form of these seed pods. So this was the rotary evaporator I used, and this was the freeze dryer. Okay, now for the study purpose, for experimentation, these are the chemicals and drugs which were used along with the extract. Extract was used actually in 3 doses, 50, 100, and 200 milligrams per kg. And I did acute toxicity study before calculating these doses. And after that, I set three doses. I fixed three doses to be utilized in this study: 50, 100, and 200 milligrams per kg of Nilemba nucifera fruit. The suspending agent, gum tragacanth powder, was used to prepare suspensions of control, reference, and three doses of the test groups. So overall, five groups were made. Three were test groups, one was control, and one was the reference drug group. And the reference drug which I used was emipramine, the prototype of the antidepressants, tricyclic antidepressants. Emipramine 25 milligram tablets were trampled and suspended in gum tragacanth 2%, and it was then administered orally in a dose of 25 milligrams per kg with the help of orogastric tube used to conduct the study. Now, first assessing the antidepressant activity of the extract, we need to induce depression in an animal, in our animal. And the animal of my study was mice, and I used force-induced swimming method or test to reveal the antidepressant activity of my fruit extract. Hence, modified pore salt 1977 method was used. The animals which I used were mice, 35 male albino mice, which were weighing 20-25 grams, were equally divided into five groups. So I placed seven animals in each group. So five groups were made. Three groups represents test group. 50, 100, and 200 milligrams per kg of Nilemba nucifera fruit extract was used. One group represents control, and the other one represents the reference group. All drugs were given orally through orogastric tube. Study duration was 15 days, and 14 doses were given from 2nd to 15th day. Now let's talk about the method itself. So force-induced swimming test consists of two sessions, the pretest and the test session. Whereas in old pore salt method, the animals were subjected to direct immersion after injecting drugs 40 minutes before test session. In the pretest session, on day one, the animals were allowed to swim separately for 15 minutes in a glass tank, and its height was 40 centimeter and diameter was 24 centimeters, and it contained 15 centimeters of water, which was maintained at 25 2 degrees plus minus Celsius, after which the animals were removed, dried, and returned to the home cages. On the second day of test session, single dose studies were conducted, and each mouse was forced to swim for 5 minutes, and variable measured was duration of immobility, that is the time at which animal halts swimming, except for those movements which keeps its head above water was recorded through stopwatch. On day 15th, same procedure was performed after completion of 14 doses. Statistical analysis. The data was subjected to analysis by taking average and standard error to the average. Other words, mean or standard error to the mean, utilizing two sample student t-test, and values of p less than 0.05 was considered noteworthy, and 0.005 was considered extremely noteworthy or highly noteworthy, highly significant. All statistical techniques were executed using SPSS software version 20. The results and discussion. The Nilemba nucifera fruit has demonstrated substantial decline in the duration of immobility in mice at doses 100 and 200 milligrams per kg on second day of test session in comparison with control. Duration of immobility was also decreased extremely noteworthy in comparison with control at the same dose of extract on 15th day of experiment. You can see on this table as well. No significant results were obtained for 50 milligrams per kg of Nilemba nucifera fruit, whereas at doses 100 and 200 milligrams per kg, if we talk about 100 specifically, then on second day, significant results were obtained, and on the 15th day, highly significant results were obtained, whereas as compared to control, and whereas 200 milligrams per kg showed highly significant results on the 15th day of dosing, and on second day the results were fine. Okay, they were significant as well. Whereas emipramine, which was the reference drug at 25 milligrams per kg, showed overall, highly significant effects at on second day and 15th day as well. Immobility responds to antidepressant effect. Hence, nilambo-nucifera fruit showed remarkable antidepressant effects, more or less similar to amiprovine at doses 100 and 200 milligrams per kg, after continuous administration for 14 days, that is up to 15th day of experiment. Now, what was the reason of it? So let's talk about the secondary metabolites present in it. It is actually a bunch of various flavonoids, alkaloids, saponins, and tannins. I told you at the start of it, and I also evaluated its phytochemical, qualitative phytochemical analysis, and it revealed, that was also a part of my PhD project, and I presented somewhere else in some other conference. So actually that study revealed that it has various alkaloids, saponins, tannins, and flavonoids in it. Flavonoids, you know, are immune boosters as well. So nephrine, lysine, and isoleucine are alkaloids found in the seeds of Nilambo nucifera fruit, have demonstrated antidepressant activities in previous studies as well. And the central effects of these alkaloids are most likely linked to serotonergic neurotransmission, particularly involving 5-HT1A receptors in mice. Hence, the antidepressant effect of Nilambo nucifera fruit could be due to the presence of these alkaloids in it. I just want to clarify one thing, that different phytochemical constituents and the secondary metabolites, especially alkaloids and other vitamins, have proven significant and demonstrated antidepressant activities by modulating the serotonergic neurotransmission. So not only depression, but the comorbidities associated with depression can also be treated by the administration of Nilambo nucifera fruit. My different articles are on it. I have revealed its anti-epileptic activity and an anxiolytic activity as well. Not only that, but also revealed its an effect on the lipids by lowering the lipid levels in rabbits. So I have documented and I have made different researches as well on its significant activities. So hence I can say that this plant is a very useful upcoming plant to be researched, and this is just a beginning of it. We have done it on lower animals. We need to do it on the higher animals as well, and not only the preclinical, but the clinical studies should be encouraged in near future to find the significant effects, to prove the significant effects of these plants clinically in patients. So with this, I want to say thank you for watching and giving me time and adjusting me as well. Thank you so much. Thank you, Miss Ashley, and conference series. Bye bye.